everybody. Thank you for clicking on this video. As you can see, I just got back from my very first Renaissance Fair, and it was super cool. I had such a good time, and it was kind of like everything and also not what I expected at the same time. I expected the costumes, and I got to see some jousting and some cool stuff, but there's also like a whole lot of other parts to it, especially because there are so many shops, and I expected a few, but I didn't expect... I'm saying expect a lot, aren't I? I didn't expect the tons of different shops and stuff that were there, which was really awesome, and there was a lot of food. I got to ride an elephant. How cool is that? I've never ridden an elephant. Have you ridden an elephant? If you have, shut up. Just, like, I don't know. Let me have the moment. Okay? It was just super cool. Had a great time. And I thought I was going to feel really stupid about dressing up, but I didn't. It was a lot of fun because most of the people there that were dressed up too, and there's no judgment or anything. And I know I've been to like several cons before. I've been to Comic-Con in San Diego 3 times. And so I've been around a ton of cosplay and stuff, but I've never done it myself just because I always feel like an idiot. So it was fun to be somewhere where... and experience that for the first time, that people don't care. They're just there to have as much fun as you, and it doesn't matter. I did get some weird looks at the McDonald's I stopped at afterwards, though. That was a little strange. And one dude was just did not seem happy when we walked in. He was like, what the hell is this? But one of the workers there was super excited, and she was just like, oh, I love it. So it was cool. It was cool. It was just an overall just a really fun experience. I got to have a giant turkey leg, which I said before, that's my goal. And I got it. I also had a couple beers. I had 3 beers, or was it 4? That is kind of something I want to bring up, is that something I'm still struggling with my weight loss is binging, and not so much binge eating, even though sometimes I still have that trouble. Binge drinking is still my problem. It's not from a getting drunk standpoint. It's from a, I just enjoy the taste of beer. I love trying different beers. What I did this weekend, that wasn't really an excuse I could have used, because it was all beer that I could have gotten anywhere else. They were only 12-ounce glasses, but I mean, still, I know I didn't need it. And there was at one point while we were there, I was like, oh, I probably shouldn't have another one, but I gave in and I did anyway. And, you know, maybe that's not that bad, but for me, that's someone that's trying to be better about what I put in my body and limit my drinking, limit my eating, I definitely made the wrong choice there. And some of the food I had there too, I mean, this was kind of a brush it off as a cheat day, but I'm having too many of those days. And this is something I really got to reel in. And it is super hard for me because over the last, I mean, couple decades, I have kind of hardwired my mind and body to accept eating bad foods and eating a lot of foods and drinking a lot. And it's so hard because there's times that I feel like I'm getting a grip on it, and there's times that I feel like I have no control over it yet. But at least it's not leaning specifically towards I have no control. It's kind of waxing and waning. It still sucks. It's still hard to deal with. And you know, I'm 2 months in to really trying to overhaul my health, and I'm trying not to let that get me down, but I thought that I would be a little bit more progressed at this point than I am. It's a little hard, but I'm just trying to stay patient, stay optimistic with it, because I'm still trying. I just really need to hold myself more accountable, which is my big problem. You know, I'm trying to use this as a way to do it. It's just, it's hard. It's harder than I thought it was going to be, honestly. And you may have noticed this. I did injure my wrist a little bit. Not entirely sure how, and it wasn't like a specific incident. It's been hurting a lot over the last few weeks, and I had been ignoring it. The last time I went to 9 Round, which was, I think, last Thursday, the very first exercise I was doing was these push-ups where I was on like an uneven surface and I'm gripping onto something as opposed to my hands are here. And I was in so much pain that after the whole workout was over, I was shaking. So I've been resting. I haven't worked out for several days. I'm not going to work out again until probably Wednesday. And I've been using this guard to try to keep it steady. And I've been icing it, and I need to be doing some heat and stuff too. But it's starting to feel a little bit better, but it's something I'm gonna have to really take it easy on for a while. So that's really my thoughts for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and please like, subscribe, comment. I would love to talk with you, so leave something in the comments so we can start a conversation, or you can also email me or hit me on Instagram. I think that info is below here somewhere. All right, I'll check in. Ow! Oh, crap. I'll check in with you guys later. See you next time. Bye.